Today we're going to take a look at the long exposure noise reduction, or LENR, setting found on most cameras and break down whether it's a good thing to leave on or off when taking photos. Let's dive in. The TLDR is long exposure noise reduction is there to reduce the overall noise in your longer exposure images. Now, what camera manufacturers classify as a long exposure is a little different between them. Most manufacturers, long exposure noise reduction will take effect on any exposures longer than 1 second. However, some manufacturers are as long as 5 or even 8 seconds. So even if the setting is turned on, you have to also be using a long enough exposure for it to have any effect. What long exposure noise reduction specifically aims to solve is two types of noise, something called thermal noise and something called hot pixels. Let's start by talking a little bit more about what hot pixels are. If you're interested in learning more about all the nerdy types of pixels, let me know down below in the comments. Now, technically, there are actually three types of pixels. There's hot pixels, dead pixels, and stuck pixels, but I'm going to refer to all of them as the same. So what a hot, stuck, or dead pixel looks like is essentially a pixel that does not act like the neighboring pixels. You have all the pixels on your sensor, sometimes 20, 30, 50 million of them, and sometimes one of them will malfunction. It'll malfunction and be pure white, pure red, pure blue, sometimes it'll be pure black, but it's not doing what it should do. And long exposure noise reduction will help fix this. Here's a very clear example of this. In this left image, you can see this white bank of hot pixels, and on the right, that same bank of pixels has been removed. The bank of pixels on the left was shot at 120 seconds with long exposure noise reduction disabled. On the right, it's the same picture, same settings. However, I enabled long exposure noise reduction, and we can see it cleaned that up. And as I click and move around this photo, there's actually a number of other hot pixels we'll find as well that were also cleaned up in the final version. Go ahead and zoom in. Here's another couple examples. We can see those were cleaned up. Here's one more example of these hot pixels. This was shot with my Canon EOS RA camera. The previous example was my Fuji X-T4. And again here, we can see some pure red pixels, some pure purple pixels that have been cleaned up with long exposure noise reduction being enabled. So long exposure noise reduction will help clean up these little extra hot pixels, dead pixels, stuck pixels around your photo. The other thing that long exposure noise reduction will do is reduce your overall thermal noise. Now, thermal noise is also sometimes called dark current. Astrophotographers would call it dark current, but essentially it's this. The longer your sensor is on for, the more time it has to build up noise. Noise is ever present. When you're taking photographs, there's always noise. There's always errant data that your sensor picks up. Sensors are analog, and they're not doing a perfect job. They see information that doesn't exist, and that's noise. And thermal noise, or dark current, is basically the type of noise that builds up over time. So if you go from a 30-second shutter speed to a 60-second shutter speed, you're gonna have twice the amount of thermal noise in that 60-second version. And long exposure noise reduction aims to reduce the overall thermal noise in the image. Now again, the longer your exposure, the more effect and more help long exposure noise reduction is going to give you. So here's a little before after with long exposure noise reduction on and off using my Canon EOS RA. On the left, we have a 4 second exposure with LENR turned off, and on the right, we have one with LENR turned on. And we can very clearly see that the amount of thermal noise, the amount of texture, graininess, everything, is reduced with the long exposure noise reduction setting turned on. So clearly I've proven that this works, right? It has an effect on your images, but how? How is it functioning? How is it doing this? Well, the cool thing about hot pixels and thermal noise is that they're both consistent image to image to image. They both depend on your ISO, your ambient temperature, and your shutter speed. And if those three things stay the same image to image, the two images will have almost identical hot pixels and thermal noise. Again, those three things are ambient temperature, shutter speed, and ISO. So what the camera does when we enable long exposure noise reduction is every time you push the shutter button, the camera actually takes two photographs. The first image is just like normal. Let's say a 30-second exposure of the Milky Way. As soon as that 30-second exposure is complete, if you have LENR enabled, your camera is gonna lock up for another 30 seconds. And during this second 30-second picture, the camera's actually leaving the shutter closed. It's taking a picture of nothing. There's no light entering the sensor. However, with nothing entering the sensor, you're still gonna get thermal noise and hot pixels, but you're not gonna get any Milky Way galaxy or whatever it is that you're shooting. And then what the camera does is it takes that second picture, which again contains thermal noise and hot pixels, and it subtracts it out of the first one. And because the consistency of ISO, ambient temperature, and shutter speed are the same between the two images, that subtraction results in a much cleaner final shot. It's a really cool process. Now, astrophotographers, this might sound familiar to you. This is called dark frame subtraction or dark frame calibration. It's something we do in astro all the time. However, LENR gives you a way to do it in the camera. Now, there are some caveats. Some cameras need to be on mechanical shutter instead of electronic shutter for this to work. So I definitely recommend checking your camera manual to find where the LENR setting is and how to enable it. Finally, let's talk a little bit about when to use it. Now, I honestly think you should use this whenever you can, because it's going to give you better image quality. I will say this, as cameras get better and noise reduction in Lightroom gets better and all of these things get better, the need for LENR has taken a little bit of a decrease over the past few years. However, it's still a setting that I will enable in many different situations. I want to spend more time on talking about when not to enable it. Think about this, if you're doing a 5-minute shutter speed and you enable LENR, your camera is locked up for double that amount of time every single time you take a picture. So if you're using 5 minutes, it's locked up for 10 minutes with every shutter press. So things like star trails, you're definitely gonna wanna turn it off. Things like Milky Way, if you're shooting repeated images that you're gonna stack together, you're gonna wanna turn it off. Time lapses, you're gonna wanna turn it off. Anything where time is really important and you need to get as many frames as quickly as possible, we're gonna disable this one. However, if you're shooting something just at night, some general purpose night photography, it's a great setting to leave on, assuming you have the time to wait for it to complete. This is one of those settings that I actually have set to the My menu on my camera or the custom menu on my camera so that I can very quickly turn it off and turn it on again. You may actually have it on right now and not noticed. If your camera's locking up for twice as long as you would expect every time you take a picture, you might want to check your menu and make sure that you don't have it on and accidentally. Finally, I want to say this. Some cameras, you're not going to need this, so I recommend you test to see whether LENR is effective for you. To test this is super simple. Set your camera up on a tripod in a really dark room. Preferably point your camera at something in the room that has a lot of different texture, detail, information, things where you can see different bits. And this has to be a dark room, like a closet with no windows. Really dark room, or do it at night. Take two pictures. Take one picture with LENR on, take another picture with LENR off. To make this test even better, I would even cycle through some different shutter speeds. Maybe start way down at a shutter speed of like 1 second, and you work your way all the way up to 30 seconds or 1 minute. Again, each image, do one with LENR on and one with LENR off. Then take a look in Lightroom, do a little side-by-side compare, and you might find that your camera, you don't really need it. And that's awesome. That'll save you time, means you're getting really good image quality out of the camera. And again, like I said, that's the direction that the industry and the technology is moving. I believe in the next 5-10 years, this setting will be obsolete. However, for me right now, it still does great things. Finally, what are the alternatives? Well, if you're gonna get into astrophotography, you're gonna be doing something a little bit more advanced called dark frame calibration. This is where we do essentially the same process. However, we shoot our dark frames, or the pictures of nothing, when we want to. Again, all that's got to match between a dark and a photo of your object or whatever you're shooting is ambient temperature, your ISO, and your shutter speed. So technically, you can shoot these calibration dark frames anytime, so long as those three things remain the same between the darks and the images of that you're photographing. Also, I should say, noise reduction in Lightroom has gotten amazing. So again, this is kind of getting to be one of those things where it might not be worth the effort for all of you. All right, everybody, I want to conclude by saying, if you have a really cool night photo or you want to share the results of this test, head over to community.rmsp.com. This is our online community where you can share photos, ask questions of fellow photographers. I'll leave a link to it down in the description. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. I would really appreciate you hitting that like button and hitting subscribe to stay up to date with future videos, and we would really appreciate seeing you in the future. Thanks, everybody, and I'll catch you in the next one.